First, what you're going to want to do is get these two screws here that hold one of the corners of each float bowl down, and also this idle adjuster. So make sure your screwdriver fits real nice. Make sure you don't strip the screws. And it'll just come right off. Put those aside. Make sure you keep everything as organized as possible. Alright, so it's 2 of 8. You never want to over-tighten any of these screws, because you're screwing into aluminum, and it'll strip real easily. These are fine threads, too. Last one. All the screws off to the side where they're not going to get lost. They're all the same length, so you don't have to worry about mixing them up. And you just pull straight outwards. Might be a little tough. Ooh-hoo! Look at that nasty mess. Good lord. So that's what can happen inside your carbs. Holy shit. Yeah, it's just like gelatin. See that? I have to wiggle a little bit. Oh, that's fucking disgusting. Alright, I'm gonna have to take these outside. Oh, shit. I got a plastic bag under this towel, so. I had to go buy some carb cleaner. I'm gonna try to loosen up some of this crud. Okay, so the bowls are off. I blasted some of the really loose, nasty stuff away. The bowl covers, anyway. Now these little guys here are your actual float bowl things or whatever. All right, so I cleaned one of the float bowls out a little bit. I've got a toothbrush, and I've let some of the carb cleaner here soak in for a minute for this other one. I had some rust there. Like I was saying before, you turn this screw down here, and gas will drain out of the bottom. And if that's clogged up with rust, it's not going to work. So I was letting it kind of sit down there. I'll hit it a couple more times with the spray. You're not really supposed to use a carb cleaner on gaskets. At least not for any extended period of time. Like, don't soak your gaskets in a dip. And really, I should be doing a dip. It's more effective. But I have... I've left it over at my friend's house. So. Okay, now to get the float bowls out, we need to get these pins out. I've got them part of the way out. It was really difficult for one of them. Took a lot of persuasion. God damn you. Alright, so after a lot of fighting, I got the pins out here. I would be able to lift them straight up, but the floats are stuck. Or the float valves are stuck like crazy. Up, this one came out. So there's your float valve. There we go. That little cone-shaped portion at the very tip. Oh, it kind of looks like a bullet. The tip is made out of rubber. And when the bowls are full, it sits down over the hole. It sits into it so that no more gas can get in. they need to be able to move freely, so they're going to need to be cleaned off. And the holes that they go into here are also going to need to be cleaned off pretty well. Now that the bowls and stuff are out, it'll be a lot easier to clean these other parts with the toothbrush. These two things here are your main jets, I believe. And the pilot jets are down in there, if I'm not mistaken. They're both going to need to be cleaned out. Okay, well, the gelled gasoline came off pretty well, but a lot of oxidation was left from, I guess, moisture that was in the carbs. And so, after brushing it down real well with the soft bristle brush here, I used a wire brush. It's pretty fine stuff. I wouldn't necessarily recommend it. If you are going to do it, stick to, just the broad surfaces and whatnot. Don't mess around with your jets and stuff like that. Be real careful if you're using wire brush, but that was the only way I was going to get that oxidation off without soaking them. Now these are the idle mixture screws. Basically tells the carbs how much fuel to give the bike at idle. These are your main jet screws. These are adjustable, these just screw in. I'll go ahead and open one up. It'll come off easily. Not too easily. Now this little piece has lots of little tiny holes all on it, and all through it. You can see through the middle of it. You're supposed to be able to. And yeah, that's going to need to be cleaned. I'm actually going to soak that. And you can see where it's gone, there's a little needle in there. That's your actual, your needle. As suction on the engine increases from higher RPMs, the carb slides, these things here, get sucked upwards. And you see the needle getting skinnier and skinnier. That lets more and more fuel through the hole. See what's going on there? It's hard to see, but way down in there are the pilot jet screws. Yeah. And it's a lot like the main jet, just smaller. It's got the holes in the sides and whatnot. Stick it in there, along with the other one, and the two pilot jets. They're gonna soak. Alright, now when you're cleaning your jets, you need to make sure that you can see through each one of these holes. You can see down in it, and there's a nice clean hole with no debris on the inside there. And what you can do is, if you have trouble getting all the holes clear with the softer brush, what you can do is get a thin piece of copper wire and poke through very gently. Make sure you get a real thin piece because you don't want to scratch up any of the surfaces. Copper's pretty soft though, so. Good way to check to see if you got the holes cleared out is to stick end of the tube in there and spray it out that way first, and then cover it up and see that. one here is not coming out properly. That's got it. And of course, do the same thing for your pilot jets. Looks like that main hole's a little clogged up on this one. But yeah, you get the idea. Just keep going until all the holes are clear. Just to make sure we got all the holes poked out. Strip this wire here. Just cut it. Now we have all these nice little thin pieces of wire to work with. And just stick it through every one of the holes. Then I'll spray it out one more time real well. Yeah, it's nice and clear. Alright, all my jets are nice and clean. Couple tips, when you're checking to see how clean the passageways are, you want to check for roundness, you know, so it needs to be consistently round. No lumpy spots or straight edges or, you know, and all the holes, it's symmetrical across the opposite side, so the holes should look exactly the same as far as the diameter and everything. And holding them up is a good way to compare. Make sure you're working with about the same size orifice. And you didn't miss something on one or the other side. But yeah, I'm going to clean off the needle valves now. Okay, here's the float bowl and the needle valve thing. There's a tab right in there. And it hooks right on there. It's sort of like a coat hanger. And just hangs there. It inserts down into the hole. You want to be real gentle with this stuff because it's delicate. And they have a preset height that they're at, and if you disturb it, it can change the way your bike runs. So you can see this has got deposits all over it. I'm just going to hit it with some spray. And toothbrush. One thing to check for is the sides on the rubber part here need to be flat, nice and flat. If you have like an indentation, a ring of indentation around it, that means it's getting worn out and may not seal correctly. They're as clean as they're going to get now. You can see the one on the left has some pretty bad pitting from the oxidation that I had to use the wire brush on. So yeah, I probably need to rebuild these things, but I'm actually only rebuilding these. This is an extra set of carbs I have, and I'm only working on them so that I can get a second bike on the road while my first one's under repairs. But anyway, next up we gotta check out the little passageways for the pilot circuit in the carb, make sure they're clear, and then I think we should be good to go because I cleared out all the big stuff earlier. Now I'm going to do what I said I was going to do before, which is test this drain thing. Yep. Looking fine. Alright, it's the tiny passages that get clogged most easily on these bikes. And if you'll notice, see down there? Right above my thumb, each side, there's a little hole. The idle screw, idle adjustment screw, mixture screw anyway, screwing it in or out pushes a needle up into that hole. So you want to make sure that when you screw it in all the way, you can see the tip of the needle. When you screw it out, you got free air in there, it's not clogged up with anything. When you open the butterfly valve and look in there, you can see four more holes behind the butterfly valves on each side. When you spray air into the pilot jet circuit, which is that one right there, stuff should come out of those four holes. The mixture should, or the spray should. So I'm gonna stick it in there and spray it. You see that?